I'm going to show you how to wire a 3-pin red-green LED to indicate whether you have power off and on your track, switching it with a double-pole, double-throw switch. So here we go. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. I get a lot of questions from emails on my webpage about situations that other modelers are having. I had several questions that were basically similar in content about the bi-color LEDs. I have some 3-pin LEDs here. I don't have any 2-pin bi-color LEDs right at the moment, but I'll show you how to do it with 2 LEDs. It's basically the same thing. I have a red and green one right here, and I'll show you how to do that second after I do the bi-color 3-pin. But I had some questions on how do I switch with a double pole, double throw switch. I want to turn off and on my power to a track on a engine facility, and I want to have an indicator on the top. When the power is off, I want it red, and when the power is on the track for that stall, I want it green. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do now with this. I hooked up my little breadboard and a double pole double throw switch. Here's the little breadboard right here. Here's the double pole double throw switch. And I'm going to show you how it's wired up, and it's very simple. So I'm going to walk you through it right after this. If you would like to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and go to my channel. Click right below the video where it says Tom's Trains and Things. Click on that, and that'll take you to my channel page, and click on playlists. And that will show you all the playlists that I have. I have them grouped into different categories by topic, so it's easy to find. So if you're looking for something on soldering, you could find it. If you're looking for electrical projects, you could find it. If you're looking for DCC, you'll find it. I have over 40 playlists on there where the videos are grouped into categories so you could find them easily. So take a look at it. Whenever you have LEDs, it's a good idea to look on the back of the package and see what the specifications are on it. The forward voltage on the red is 1.8 volts, and on the green it's 2.1 volts. You want to make sure what your trigger voltage is on it. You don't want to apply too much voltage on it. Now, since it's 1.8 and 2.1, I'm going to be using the 3.3 voltage off of my computer power supply. And you could use a wall wart, you could use anything that you want to get that voltage, but make sure that you check the specifications on the package first. Other LEDs may not be this voltage, it may be some other voltage, like I showed you on these right here. These are 12 volt. So the voltage on LEDs vary depending on what LEDs you get, who the manufacturer is. There's a lot of different reasons why they have different voltages, but make sure that you know what the voltage is. And you just want to go a little bit over what the forward voltage is on the LED. You don't want to apply 12 volts onto one of these. On the green side, I'm using a 470 ohm resistor, and on the red side I'm using a 220 ohm resistor just to even out the intensity of the red and green so they look basically the same. Here is the wiring diagram, and I have it split up into two different areas. The one side of the double pole double throw switch carries the diodes or the LEDs. The other side carries the signal for the track. And you're only going to be using two terminals on that switch on the one side for the track, because all you have to do is disconnect one side of the track just to cut power on it, like any other track. So that's all we have to do on that. Before you use your double pole, double throw switch, you're going to want to test it with a meter because not all of them are manufactured alike. Now on this one here, when the switch is in this direction, these two pins right here have continuity, and then these two over here do not. And then you switch it over this way, and then these two pins have the continuity. But there are other manufacturers that are made just the opposite of it, and it goes by the way your arm is pointing. So if it's like this, these two pins right here have the continuity, and when it's this way, these two pins right here have the continuity. So you have to test it with the meter, put your meter on it, and just put it on. You could put it on your audio part or your ohms for resistance and just check it going back and forth like that to see which one has the continuity for which direction of the switch. And you won't go wrong with that. If you take a look at some of my other videos on LEDs, you'll be able to see how I test what resistors to use with it, with the particular LEDs. Not all LEDs are the same. Not all resistors are going to be the same. A lot of people tell you to use a 1K ohm resistor on it. That's good for some LEDs, but not all LEDs. So you have to check them out. Check out my playlist that I have for the LEDs. I show you how to test them and how to play around with them to see which resistors will be the best for that. And that's what I did with this on this one here. I just I started out with 1K and I worked my way down. The 1K made them too dim, so I worked my way down to 470 and a 220 ohm resistor on there. So let's start looking at this and how we did all this on here. On any breadboard that you use, you're going to have a power bus on either side, and that's what this is right here. These two that I colored here, the black and the red, is the power bus. The black is the negative right here, and the red is the positive. Now, continuity on these bands go this way here, on both sides here, but don't jump over the center part. And this doesn't jump over the center part right here. So I had to put a jumper from this power bus, the positive power bus, over to here for the positive that goes to the center of the double pole, double throw switch. Now I have the wires on here on this breadboard the same way that they are on the double pole, double throw switch. And let me try to get that straightened out there a little bit. So on the center terminal, that's going to go directly to your positive voltage wherever you pick it up. Okay. Now on the negative side, that is going to go on to the center pin of the LED on the bicolor LED. Now remember, I'm using a 3-pin LED. Now on either side I have a resistor on it, and on the red side I have the 220 ohm, and on the green side I have the 470 ohm right here. And all I did was put it in adjacent holes on my breadboard, so it only moves it out just one. So the red, I use a red wire coming over here to the switch, and on the green I use the green wire coming over here on the switch. Now what you want to do is, coming off the red side, you want it to go to one side of your double pole, double throw switch, and coming off the green side, you want to go to the other side of the double pole, double throw switch. Now, if I can get this thing straightened out right here, you can see that this one here to the red is going right there. This one here to the green is going on this side. Don't worry about the red ones right now. That's the other circuit that we're going to work on for the DCC signal. All right, now that's where everything goes on here. So I'm going to hook this up to my power supply right here. All right, make sure those don't touch right there. And I'm going to turn the power supply on. Now you can see that we have the green indication right now. So I'm going to flip the switch over. And we have the red indication. You got the red. You got the green. You got the red. You got the green. Now what we want to do on this with the green, we're going to use these two wires right here for our power to the track. And what we could do, we could have either one of them coming from our bus and either one of them going to the track. But what you want to do is you want to gap that track right there. So whenever it's in this position with the green, these two wires right here, one's going to go to your bus and the other one is going to go to your track. And so whenever we switch it the other way and have the red indication, you're not going to have any power going right here through from the bus wire to the track. Since I don't have the two-pin bicolor LED, I'm going to use two LEDs, one red, one green, and use it in a three-pin configuration. The only thing different about this is I don't know the values of these LEDs because they came in packages that I bought, I think, at a train show. They came, you know, sorted LEDs in there, so I'm not sure what it was. So what I have is I have a 1K on the green and a 1.2K on the red. And I have it exactly wired up exactly the same. When I get in my two-pin LEDs, bicolor LEDs, I'll do another demonstration on that. It takes less wires. It only takes two wires on your double pole, double throw switch, and it takes three resistors. So we have to do it a little bit differently. So I'll show you this. I'll light this up for you and we'll go from there. Let me hook this up and we'll show you what it looks like on there. Hopefully that cleared things up for a lot of you on using a three-pin LED. Now, I'm going to do some more projects, but I'm going to do some with the Arduino board, and that's going to be coming up maybe in February and March. Take a look for the ESU decoder tester on Saturday. That's what's coming up then, and we'll see you. I'm going to put this down like this. And I just destroyed it, huh? Yes, I did. But anyway, you get the idea.